Hello and welcome back to Football Daily, where with the end of the season fast approaching, we've decided to review the worst pieces of business of the last 12 months. Let's get going. 10. Sebastian Rudy. It seems harsh to blame one team's travails this season on the arrival of one player, especially when that club has been as bad as Schalke. But the €16 million arrival of Bayern Sebastian Rudy at the Veltins Arena simply hasn't worked out. After the departures of Leon Goretzka and Max Maher for free last summer, Tedesco was left with a frantic search to replace their combined defensive output of 9.5 tackles and interceptions per 90, and plumped for Rudy. Despite only being unavailable for one game this season, 13 players have played more than his 1,100 minutes at the time of writing. And with a poor passing accuracy of under 81% and just 3.2 tackles and interceptions per 90 in a defensive side, it's fair to say the acquisition of their third most expensive signing hasn't gone to plan. Yes, the departures of Kehrer and Howardes last summer, followed by Naldo in January, combined with a roster of underperforming strikers, haven't helped, but someone had to take the fall for Schalke, winning just 8 of their 32 Bundesliga games to date. And that man, I'm afraid, is Rudy. 9. Jean-Michel Seri. Fulham fans were rightly delighted when Ivory Coast midfielder Jean-Michel Seri walked through the doors of Craven Cottage in July 2018. After all, this was a player who had shone during his 3 years at Nice, so much so that just a year before he had almost joined Barcelona before the deal collapsed at the last minute. Unperturbed by the collapse of what he labelled his dream move, Seri set about putting in another excellent season under Lucien Favre. He proved himself to be a unique mix of defensive solidity with 2.3 tackles and interceptions and creativity with 1.3 dribbles and 2.2 key passes per 90. This prompted Slavisa Djukanovic to spend £27 million of its £100 million spending to bring the diminutive midfielder to the world's most competitive league. Now, Fulham have brought in 15 different players since last summer, and arguably only two have come off, Mitrovic and Ryan Babel. So to lay the blame solely at Seri's door when they've already conceded 9 more goals than anyone during the entirety of the 17-18 campaign would just be wrong. But playing alongside a myriad of midfield partners, Seri hasn't been able to produce his best, with his key passes dropping 15% on last year's tally and his completed dribbles by a massive 59%. Meaning that Seri will likely leave this summer with his reputation tarnished from his solitary year in the Premier League. But one move that simply can't go wrong is you hitting subscribe and the notification bell, which will keep you up to date with all our content. 8. Alexander Golovin. Alexander Golovin was, alongside Takashi Inoue and Juan Quintero, one of the surprise packages of the 2018 World Cup. Playing for the host Russia alongside previously unheralded names like Cheryshev and Zuba, Golovin shone with his 3-goal contributions propelling Russia to an unlikely quarterfinal spot. Following their exit to eventual finalist Croatia on penalties, a scramble for a signature ensued, with Monaco winning the race, signing him for £27 million, the third highest expenditure in their history. Has it come off? Not a bit. Golovin has just 2 goals and 2 assists to his name in nearly 2,000 Ligue 1 minutes. Normally we would just put this down to playing in a struggling team who have scored just 35 goals in 36 league games, or the fact he is just 22. But his numbers are a little concerning. Just 1 key pass and 1 dribble per 90, and a combined expected goals and assists of 0.25 per 90. For context, his expected goals of 0.17 per 90 is the same as Scott McTominay, and only narrowly ahead of Cardiff's Sean Morrison. Golovin certainly needs to step up his game drastically in 19-20. 7. Javier Pastore. If Javier Pastore were to retire tomorrow, he could be reasonably satisfied with his career. Having first shot to prominence at Palermo, where he won Serie A Young Player of the Year, he then went on to win 12 trophies in 7 years at PSG, whilst accumulating 29 caps for his country. But delve a little deeper into the Argentine statistics and you can come away feeling slightly underwhelmed. He hasn't played over 1,000 minutes in any of his last 4 seasons, and hasn't passed double figures for goal contributions since 2014-15. Now, mostly we can put that down to injuries. After all, the Cordoba-born number 10 suffered 18 separate injuries which kept him out for 79 games across his time in Paris. But this made it all the more baffling that Roma were prepared to fork out £22 million to bring him to the Stadio Olimpico last summer. Since then, it's gone as predicted. In early September, he injured his calf, keeping him out of action until mid-April, meaning that their marquee summer signing has played just 574 minutes at a cost of over £38,000 per minute played. What a disaster. 6. Alireza Yahenbash. From the injury-ridden to the underused, it's fair to say that Alireza Yahenbash's £17 million transfer from AZ Alkmaar to Brighton hasn't gone as hoped. Yes, the 47-capped winger did miss 2 months of the season with a hamstring injury, but he's been fit now for 4 months, yet he's still been limited to under 1,000 minutes of Premier League action. You'd think that Chris Hughton's side, who have been woeful going forward, with only Huddersfield having a worse attack according to expected goals, would benefit from utilising the Iranian, who provided 33 goal contributions in the Eredivisie last campaign. But it seems unfair to blame blame Houghton, because when the 25-year-old has been called upon, he's barely shone, with just 0.4 key passes per 90 and a 31% take-on success rate. At 25, there is still plenty of time for him to turn it around, but with Houghton failing to make any of Bissouma, Bernardo and Jahan Bash regular starters, perhaps it'll take a change of management for Seagulls fans to see the best of their record signing. 5. Riyad Mahrez. A quick look at Riyad Mahrez's statistics of 7 goals and 7 assists in 32 league and Champions League games doesn't look awful on paper. But bear in mind that he's playing for arguably the best side in Premier League history, a team that could well win 198 points over the last two seasons while scoring 2.6 goals per game. Man City fans would surely have hoped their club record £60 million signing would contribute more than 11.5% of their league and Champions League goals, especially when Sané and Sterling contribute 23% and 28% respectively. Mahrez's often ponderous and predictable play mean that he hasn't lived up to City's exceptional standards as of yet. And what's more, since his arrival, Sané has played over 550 fewer league minutes than last year. If his continued presence continues to limit Sané's game time to the point of exit, he might well be remembered as one of the citizens' worst transfers of all time, given the context. 4. Thibaut Courtois. There is no doubting that Courtois had a strong World Cup. He produced arguably the standout goalkeeping performance, making 9 saves in Belgium's superb 2-1 victory over Brazil and 27 saves in 6 games as the Red Devils finished third. The Golden Glove winner then came back from Russia and, in an effort to force through a transfer to Real Madrid, refused to turn up for Chelsea training, eventually getting his £31 million move. This enraged the Blues community, and Courtois burnt more bridges at his unveiling, revealing, "I've come to a club that I've always wanted to play for. I've never kissed the badge before, but I have to today." For Atletico fans who watched Courtois make 154 appearances for the club, winning a league title, a Copa del Rey and a Europa League along the way, this was quite simply disgusting. So it's safe to say there were a fair few happy people when Courtois and Real's season went up in smoke. 15 points behind Barcelona, having conceded 7 more league goals at the time of writing, and knocked out of the Champions League at the last 16 stage, Los Blancos have had a season to forget. What's more, since Zidane's return, Courtois has played just 2 of their 9 games. He now has a major battle to win over his new manager, to the delight of Chelsea and Atleti fans. 3. Malcolm. At the end of the 2017-18 campaign, Malcolm was on top of a wave. He'd exploded in his third season with Bordeaux, scoring 12 and assisting 7 in 35 Ligue 1 games. In one of the most bizarre transfer situations of all time, Malcolm was minutes away from joining Roma, with the Giallorossi lining up at the airport ready to serenade his arrival, only for him to sign for Barcelona at the 11th hour. His €41 million move to the 26-time Spanish champions left then Roma sporting director Monchi threatening legal action. Ultimately, we don't blame Malcolm for choosing Barcelona over Roma. After all, when the opportunity to play for the 5-time European champions in front of 99,000 people alongside the likes of Messi and Suarez comes up, it takes a brave man to turn them down. Valverde, already struggling to effectively integrate players of the quality of Ousmane Dembele and Coutinho, has limited the 11-capped Brazilian to just 4 starts in the league and Champions League. Now, unless they bought the 22-year-old just to fill in for the Copa del Rey, something we highly doubt, then this signing has so far been an unremitting failure. 2. Fred. We were tempted to include another of Pep Guardiola's failed signings in this list in Jorginho, but it felt ridiculous to include someone who has played a key role in a Champions League finish and potential Europa League triumph. It seems far more apt to include 26-year-old Brazilian Fred in our list. Stolen from under Pep's nose for £53 million, the 11-cap midfielder came in as a virtual unknown. He had made 155 appearances for Shakhtar Donetsk across the 5 years since joining them from Internacional, and had shown signs of promise in the Champions League. Last year, his superb performances, in which he combined 2.9 dribbles with an 87% completion rate and 4 tackles and interceptions per 90, had helped the Miners to an unlikely last 16 spot. But since joining Manchester United, he's been limited to just over 1,000 Premier League minutes, with 14 players having played more than him. With the Red Devils set for a massive summer of upheaval, it's unclear whether Fred will be part of their long-term vision. 1. Thomas Lemar. Before we start this section, it's important to note that French forward Thomas Lemar is still just 23 and has the vast majority of his career ahead of him. But there can be no debate. His £63 million transfer to Atletico Madrid has been a complete catastrophe to date. You can see why Simeone was enticed by Lemar. After all, the Guadeloupe-born forward had scored 11 and assisted 18 league goals for Monaco over the preceding 2 years. Keen to add some width to his little and large partnership up front, the Argentine wanted to diversify his attack. But despite being given 36 opportunities in the league and Champions League to prove his worth, Lemar has so far contributed a paltry 7 goals. In a side that has scored fewer league goals than 16th place Levante at the time of writing, Lemar needed to shine. but his three league goals are level with outgoing Rocky Blanco's stalwart Diogo Godin. The most concerning thing is that it doesn't even seem like Lemar is underperforming. His goals per 90 ratio of 0.1 is exactly the same as his expected goals, and it's the same story with his expected assists. Just 1.2 dribbles and 1.8 key passes per 90 represent a poor return on Atleti's investment, and has been a crucial reason behind their highly forgettable season.
So I hope you enjoyed that video, guys. Let me know what you thought in the comments down below. And make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell so you never miss one when we produce it. See you next time, guys.